All right, time now to kick it with Kenny, who has a furry little friend over there.
It stinks, man.
It really
stinks. Is she de-skunked or de-whatever they call
We're about to find out in the next 2.5 minutes.
I'm telling you, man, because her tail is pointing in your direction.
Yeah, that's it. See, this table's on wheels, Wayne. I can adjust to the limit. Okay, hanging out with our great friends, Harvey and Michelle. Howls and owls happening at the owls and howls and howls and owls happening at the Natural History Museum. Great fundraiser for you guys. So this is a chance, and Harvey, I didn't realize it until you mentioned over 100 animals you guys have there, so that's pretty cool. Yeah. So Michelle, who is this?
So this is Stanley the Striped Skunk. Mm-hmm. He's one of our newest members of the museum animal family.
Oh, he's new, so is he trained not to squirt on Kenny?
Sure.
Yeah. you didn't sound too confident, Michelle.
So tell us about Stanley here.
So Stanley was orphaned this spring in a litter of four, but he was unable to be released by the rehabber because he has a deformed palate in his mouth, and she was worried about his ability to be able to eat. So far, he has had not much trouble eating for us.
He's doing a good job there. Yeah.
But he does sneeze a lot, so I'm not sure how that would affect his survival in the wild. But he's pretty sneezy.
So in essence, you guys rescued Stanley.
Yes. Yeah. So he wouldn't survive, most likely, in the wild if we hadn't taken him in.
That's a cool thing about our Perkins Wildlife Center, that we don't actually do the wildlife rehabilitation, but almost all of the animals that we have, coyotes and the otters and the rest, were all animals that at one point were either injured or orphaned and needed to be rehabilitated, and then for some reason they were determined to be unreleasable, and so we're a destination for those animals, and then they get new life as educational ambassadors.
Very good. Now, he's descended, right? Is he?
Yes, he
very
is.
Very good. I just want to make sure. I don't want to make him upset and find out the wrong way. So how has Stanley, how has he been doing since you guys have passed?
He's been doing great. He's just a few months old, so he's still not full grown, but he's food motivated and pretty smart, so we've been training him for program use, and he's settled right into life, lounging around in hammocks and running on a big exercise wheel.
Eating his nice expensive diet. Yeah. Stanley likes the good life.
He's got it made pretty much.
Okay, and Harvey, the event takes place when and how can people get tickets?
It's this coming Saturday, and it goes from 10 until 3. Right. And it will feature all of the animals at the museum, including Stanley, if you want to have an up-close and personal experience. And if kids want to come in their Halloween costumes, they're encouraged to do so. It should be a lot of fun, and they'll learn about our enrichment and our training and behavioral husbandry programs as well.
Awesome, and get to see Stanley. Okay, hey Stanley, point that way toward Wayne. Yeah, he's right over there. He's right there. All right, we're gonna. Oh, I get the host, Stanley. Oh, guess what, Wayne?
I'm gonna
point
there.
In your direction. Chris, like, stay there. There he is. All right, we're gonna go back to you now.
Kenny has found a new friend.
Oh, nothing like cuddling a skunk.